and final band here on this stage. So closing out our evening, this is our PHS Jazz Ensemble. They are the group that meets zero period, so bright and early before the school day begins. We are opening up with a really fun chart titled Cold Duck Time. And so Christian is going to be joining us for this opening number. And we're just ready to get things going. So hope you enjoy this one. Gentleman on alto sax, Mason on Barry sax, and Kyle on trumpet. Also again featuring our guest artist, Christian Pepin tonight. So we are now going to kind of switch gears, and this next tune is titled Just the Two of Us. So it might be a tune that you may be familiar with once you hear it. So yeah, we're going to take it away.
Thank you.
happening, and just also making sure to highlight our solo performers. So in that we had alto solo, a little alto solo in that, Jelwin, and then Felix on tenor sax. We also had Cheston on drums back there alongside with Christian through a little bit of that percussion breakout. And we are going to now get into our next chart title, Cuban. What is this? Cuban Overture. So it kind of has like a stopping point in the middle, but we're gonna keep going. So just kind of hold the applause until the very end of this music selection. It's just gonna take you on a really awesome music journey, and we're gonna go for it. Yeah? Okay, he's ready. We're ready. Thank you. awesome. There's so much great energy, and it's really crazy to say we're almost ready to close out our evening together. So, you know, a few things about just being able to bring Christian in is that he actually showed up on, we had a rehearsal Tuesday night, so he drove out here and worked with two of our bands that evening, and then he also drove out Wednesday morning to make sure that he had an opportunity to rehearse with all three of our ensembles, and also gave them, you know, as a clinician, just worked with them on improving musically and how to just, you know, listen and work together. And it was really great having him here and just, you know, be able to connect not just with them, but our students being able to connect with a musician and performer such as him. And I just found out that he is actually going on tour. And so I'm gonna pass him the microphone because I don't know all the details and I don't wanna mess this up. So I'm gonna let him go ahead and talk a little bit about that.
How you guys doing? Wow. How you guys doing, Christopher Kai? Yeah, get excited. All right, first and foremost, it is a complete honor and a pleasure to be here. This is my second time here, but my first time as an actual like guest artist. The first time I was here, I was actually with my boys. I'm sure you guys know them. He's actually here in the audience right now, the director, one of the baddest trumpet players here in the Bay, Mr. Bill Ortega, over there in the corner. It's great to know that, you know, for me as an educator and someone who has been a huge advocate when it pertains to the arts, music in schools, I came from just literally out the womb in music, and literally they just gave me two sticks and I was already in class by then. So it's great for me to see this, and especially of this caliber, and more importantly, I mean, please give it up for Ms. Martinez, who is killing it. I mean, when I look at her, she reminds me a lot of why I started going into education and why I wanted to dedicate my time in my early years when I was teaching in schools, I was touring a lot in different schools, but I was also still a full-time musician, and being a full-time teacher is a lot of work, it's a lot of dedication, it's a lot of sacrifice. Some of you may know, some of you may not know, it's a lot of hours where we, you know, stay up from the wee hours, you know, looking at charts, printing out large amounts of papers, and just for, you know, one song. Sometimes, you know, an entire ensemble, in this case, an entire concert. And, you know, you guys may think, oh man, that's a lot, but really it's a lot of time, and most importantly, it's a lot of dedication, and it shows to the caliber and how much care she really cares about this particular group, about the school, and yeah, no, definitely, give it up. It's important for you guys to really, you know, I salute you for that, and I thank you for continuing that. It's not easy. As someone who knows, I mean, I didn't say I wanted to go, I quit, but I basically, like I told her the other day, I was like, look, I do miss this, but it is, I try to give as much as I can because, I mean, this is always going to be a part of me. This is always going to be, you know, I live and breathe music, so any and all styles of music, it doesn't matter. It's just, that's what I am, and that's who I'm always going to be. But in the daytime, you know, you gotta, I'm one of those people, I like to venture and try different things, so in my case, fast forward, I've been able and honored to perform with many different artists from many different styles. I will be going on tour again with an Ethiopian artist who is considered one of the top Ethiopian, if not the creator of Ethio Jazz, named Mulatu Astake. Some of you may or may not know. It's very complex, it's very mathematically inclined for people, particularly for like trumpets and sax. It's a huge thing, and as far as the percussionist goes, I take over 90% of the original role as far as for the lead guy, Mulatu, who's also a percussionist and a vibraphonist. But aside from that, it's like I wouldn't be in that position, and I would not have been to where I've been able to go and achieve these different things if it wasn't for this particular, like my roots, essentially, aside from being in church and so forth, like this was my training room. This was where I learned how to read. This is where I learned how to become a professional musician. This is where I learned respect, humbleness, you know, the whole works. And as a musician, some of you guys may think, oh, he just travels and like you get to see all the world and blah, blah, blah. Really, you get to see maybe this much, because if you're busy, you really don't get to really experience it. But the experience and the gratification of it is being on stage and being in front of you guys, being able to give ourselves a bit of ourselves, and all this starts here. So my message for all you guys that are on the stage right now is, if you guys want to take this, I mean, there's two ways. You can take it as a hobby, or you can take it as a career. And if this is something you want to take as a career, then just know and treat it as such, with respect, with honor, and really paying homage to those way before you. Because all the stuff that you're going to learn right now, what you hear in this day, it's cool. But they also had to learn from the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, until now, right? So study that. Like, really dig yourself in and really learn everything you possibly can. Advance in everything. Never get bored. And if you do, try something else. Because, you know, music for me, it's life. It's given me an entire opportunity to travel the world more than once. And I've seen a lot of things, and I've experienced a lot of great things. And I think that, you know, it should be something that should be in all schools. And man, and for you, the parents, the, you know, aunts, uncles, everybody, all you families, and even the kids, like, continue to support, tell your people, tell your friends, tell your communities, like, music genuinely, this place, like, it reminds me of home. So, like, you should definitely, like, all these seats should be filled every time there's a concert. Doesn't matter from where. I know traffic sucks, because believe me, it was terrible coming over here, but that's my first time. Wow. For all you guys that are coming from the city here, I'm sorry. That's terrible. Why would you do that? But I get it. But more importantly, really, really support this school. Like, go in, give what you can, do what you can to really nurture and cultivate this, because I promise you, if you guys do that, every one of these kids are gonna have that opportunity to really be able to where I was, and if not, to even larger heights. So that's really, I mean, I was only gonna do like a 2-minute speech, but realistically, yeah, that was like, that's my encouragement. I thank you guys for coming down and really giving back to music and keeping music alive. So thank you for having me. It's a complete honor and a pleasure. Again, Ms. Martinez, thank you so much. And you guys are killing it. All three groups, so please give it up for all three groups, because they all killed it. Right? Doesn't matter what level. They're amazing. And thank you guys for having me. And I look forward to coming back some concert.
So, just as I did in all of our groups, before we actually begin our final tune, there's quite a few seniors that are sitting on this stage, so I want to make sure to highlight and acknowledge those members. So seniors, if you could please go ahead and stand up. I know we have pretty much our whole trumpet row in the back, and then the trombone stand up, senior members. So these folks have been very important in this music journey this year. Quite a few of them also started their 9th grade year here and have been in jazz all 4 years. So it's really great to just, they wanted to continue. And then some we picked up along the way and we're like, where have you been? You know, so we wish we could have had you sooner. But thank you all to the seniors that are here tonight. And I, you know, we'll be continuing our jazz journey next year. If you have, oh, thank you, seniors. Go ahead and have a seat. They're looking at me like, can we please sit down? So when our performance calendar for next year comes out, please do, you know, try and save those dates and come join us for these music events here. And you know, just help spread the word. Even if you can't come, share those, you know, share the info on social media. We try and do as much as we can to promote in that way. So if you can at least do that to, you know, pass it along, then we really appreciate your help and effort in doing so. So we are going to close out tonight with Jalapeno Dreams, and you'll hear a few soloists. I'm not gonna call them out, but I think we've heard from almost all of them this evening. It's going to feature our saxophone section. It's going to feature our trumpet section. It pretty much is a full ensemble feature at some point. So, and we're gonna hear a little bit of a drumming percussion back and forth over here with Tristan on drums and Christian on congas. So this is gonna close us out for the evening, Jalapeno Dreams.
Thank you.
enjoyed our evening together, everyone. Again, Christian Pepin over here, PHS Jazz Ensemble, PHS 7th Period Jazz and 9th Grade Jazz. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming out tonight. So much appreciate you all for being here. And yeah, this was a lot of fun. Great way to close out the school year, final concert. Everyone, have a great night.